Hey everybody, welcome back to another video reaction from your resident psychotherapist, here to dissect the lyrics, break things down on a pumped up Juice Wrld day. We're talking about Doom today. This is going to be great. Like this, subscribe it, pass it on to your friends, and I am going to learn a lot from you, and I'm going to try to give you my perspective from the mental health side of things about what these lyrics mean. So I cannot wait to dive in to Juice Wrld. Without further ado, let's check out Doom. So ready.
Toxic people, but it feels like it's just me and her in the room. I'd rather me die before she, so I mix drugs up trying to find my doom.
Oh man, this is good. This is different. Like, I feel like I never know what's coming with Juice. And this to me is like a more upbeat rhythm. Like the song is, it's upbeat. It's encouraging. Like it seems happier to me. Of course, the lyrics then go right back into toxicity, but I kind of, That's my favorite part so far, of, you know, a room full of toxic people, but it feels like it's just me and her in the room. And I'm hoping that means a positive. To me, that's what that sounds like. Like, I just want to focus on me and her, and there's toxic people all around us. And here we go, trying to mix the drugs, trying to get the feeling, trying to find the doom. And it's almost that death wish piece of needing to use and needing to try to find the next high. So many times people try to find the next high because that's the only way for them to feel, and, you know, to feel that freedom, to feel that escape, to feel that release. Otherwise, all they feel is pain, depression, sadness. And the sad part about addiction is that's what it does. It feeds, like when you get off of a drug, it is a downer. It brings you down. And so the only way to get back up is to get back on them again. So Great start.
The room full of toxic people, but it feels like it's just me and her in the room. I'd rather me die before she, so I mix drugs up trying to find my doom, trying to find my doom, 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 trying to find my doom, trying to find my doom, 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 doom.
Oh, this is it. Like, this seems like the beginning of what his story would be, right? Like, he's putting it out there. I know I've got problems here. And, you know, I walk through Hollywood, which is, right, like this fantasy land, this pretendville. And, you know, he's a pretty straight up guy. Like, he, you know, he says it like it is. And, you know, so much is going on. I feel like this is describing, you go from nothing to everything in a short period of time, and all of a sudden, man, when you go from broke to rich, you know, to finding love again, like all of a sudden everything's in front of you. You ever see somebody who wins the lottery, especially people who don't have much money and they win the lottery? So often within a couple of years they are broke again. In fact, they're so broke, they're broker than they were before, because it is too much too soon. They're not able to manage it. They don't have balance in their life. They don't have perspective. They don't have priorities. And it's very hard when everything's thrown at you or put in front of you, from money to drugs to sex to, you know, people, attention, you know, everybody falling at your feet. It's so hard to deal with. I feel like what he's setting up here is the doom, is the downfall after all of this. But this is a great beginning to his story.
Astonished. So much has happened in the last few months. From broke to rich, to finding love again. I said so much has happened in the last 3 months. More drugs to mix, so I don't pick up the phone no more. New phone, who is this? Uh-oh. You get some nerve, dumb hoe.
So this to me describes where he's, you know, made it. And now somebody, some woman calls him back up from the past to say, hey, how's it going? Remember me? And he's like, you got to be kidding me. Where were you before? Like, you treated me like I was garbage, or you dumped me, or you left me, or you, and now you're here. Isn't that something? I could pay your mortgage, but man, now my shoes cost your car. Like, he's just putting it right in front of her face. Man. Oh, you got to hear this.
I'm known to be too cool. There's a room full of toxic people, but it feels like it's just me and her in the room. I'd rather me die before she, so I mix drugs up, trying to find my doom, trying to find my doom, 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 trying to find my doom, trying to find my doom, 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 trying to find my tomb. Ended up finding you, I assume that you were gonna leave me overconsumed, consumed, 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 yeah. I'm fucked up, yeah, but you already know. What's your favorite color besides blue? You're always blue, you always been the one for me, you knew that too. Fucked up, drunk driving on the avenue. Wrist hanging out the window, let the rollie do what it do. Keep an all black faux nickel on me too.
Oh man, so this is the story. You go backwards to him of being messed up and talking about just the depression, and especially the girl that he's with. I don't know what the story is with this one girl, if that's his girlfriend or if that's somebody he's been with for a long time, but it sounds like kind of a more depressing relationships from the beginning when I heard it. And, you know, just that deal of always being down, but you've always been the one for me. Like, it's still the one for him, and that whole blue thing. This is interesting. So, what's an all black four nickel? I'd be curious to know what that is, because the Rolex is the Rolls. Is either the Rolex, right? I'm assuming that's the Rolex. I'm guessing, but let me know. But man, messed up, drunk driving, just kind of chilling. Hand out the window, doesn't really care. This is all the danger stuff that he does. The things that he does to just say, I don't care, whatever. I'm just going to live it and let it roll.
Fucked up, drunk driving on the avenue. Wrist hanging out the window, let the rollie do what it do. Keep an all black faux nickel on me too.
Is that a 45? Is that like a gun or something?
Fucked up, drunk driving on the avenue. Wrist hanging out the window, let the rollie do what it do. Keep an all black faux nickel on me too, on me too. No, I can't be fooled, I ain't playing by your rules. I'm known to lose my cool, but that's cool, cause I'm known to be too cool. There's a room full of toxic people, but it feels like it's just me and her in the room. I'd rather me die before she, so I mix drugs up, trying to find my doom, trying to find my doom, 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 trying to find my doom, trying to find my doom, 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 doom.
Man, oh boy. This is like, first of all, there's the music, which I loved, like this music. I loved the whole beat of this song. And the story, like he had a lot of story in there. I could visualize. That's how I really like a song, when I can see the lyrics, hear the music, hear how he sings it, and picture it in my mind. And that's when I really think it's a solid song, that I can visualize what's happening and the ups and the downs that go with him and this relationship stuff that he's talking about, but also the doom of like trying to find his doom. Like when you're trying to find your doom, you're purposely self-destructive. Like you're just bringing yourself down. And that is why people enter my office, or I should say when people enter my office. And the challenge there is, it's easy to always find a reason to give up. It's easy to always find a reason it's not going to work. It's hard to stop and say, how can I have some type of hope or some type of energy to be able to make something go better tomorrow better than it was today. And that's where the help comes in. It's very hard to do on our own when we're already down, but he's trying to find his doom. He's trying to, you know, it's basically the ending of everything. And man, what a story. This is where I lean on y'all. Like I want to learn from the Juice WRLD community, the 999, which I am loving and appreciating you're taking me, who's like ignorant to this, and being able to teach me and show me without totally embarrassing me, because I don't know all the lingo and all the stuff that he's saying, but I want to learn that so that I can apply it to the next song and the next song and the next song. Unbelievable song. Love it. Love my Juice days, and love all of y'all being able to comment, reply, tell me, teach me, show me, and I'll be right there with you. So thank you so much. Like, subscribe, pass it on. And thanks for allowing me to be a part of the Juice WRLD community for this little time. And I can't wait to see you on the next video reaction.